Good morning, students. Hope all of you are doing well and stay safe at your home. So today I'm going to discuss about the first chapter, matter. So at first I want to discuss about what is matter. So all of you already you have studied in earlier classes that anything that has mass and occupies space is called matter. And also it may be perceived by our senses. So the smallest particle of dust to the largest star in the universe and even human beings, all are made up of matter. And also we know that all matters are exist in three states. So what is this? The matter exists in three states. What is the name of those states? First one is that solid, then liquid, and number three is gas. So what is matter? The matter, it has mass, it occupies space, and also it may be perceived by our senses. Okay, by senses, the sense of sight, the sense of smell, or the sense of touch. Okay. So, if you take one glass of water, if you keep it top of your table, so it occupies some space. So that we can see, tell that the matter occupies space. Now, if you hold one book and afterwards if you hold many books, then it becomes very, very heavy. So because of it, matter has mass. And the another point is that it may be perceived by our senses. So by the sense of sight, the sense of smell, or the sense of touch. Next part is the characteristics. Of matter. The characteristic of matter, all matter regardless of its physical state is made up of elements. So all matter are made up of element. Okay. So combine, all matters are made up of elements combined with each other in different proportion. Elements are the basic building blocks. So the elements are the basic building blocks of all matter. So now is the question about that, what is element? So an element and element is defined as a substance that cannot be subdivided into two or more simpler substances by any physical or chemical method. So there are 118 elements will be there. So there are 118 elements. In 118 elements, 92 are natural and 26 are synthetic. But if we further divide this element, what we will get? We will get atom. So the smallest unit of an element is called atom. So atom is that smallest unit of element. So what is the definition of an atom? So an atom is defined as the smallest unit of an element that may or may not have an independent existence, but always takes part in a chemical reaction. So the atom is the smallest unit of element. So the definition is that atom is defined as the smallest unit of an element that may or may not have an independent existence, but always takes part in a chemical reaction. So now if we take two or more than two atoms combined together to make a molecule. So what is molecule? When two or more atoms combine together to form a molecule. So, what is the definition of a molecule? A molecule is define as the smallest unit of matter that has an independent existence and carries the physical and chemical properties of the matter. So here the molecule is defined as the smallest unit of matter that has an independent existence. But you notice that in atom, it may or may not have an independent existence. So this is the difference. In atom is the smallest unit of an element that may or may not have an independent existence. But in a molecule, it is the smallest unit of matter that has an independent existence and carries the physical and chemical properties of the matter. So, for example, O2 means oxygen molecule. In oxygen molecule, there have two oxygen atoms. So this is one oxygen atom, this is another oxygen atom. So when two oxygen atoms combine together to make a one oxygen molecule, same like a hydrogen molecule. Here two hydrogen, one hydrogen atom and another hydrogen atom to combine together and to make one hydrogen molecule. Same like if you consider water molecule. So water molecule, so H2O. Here two hydrogen atom and one oxygen atom, so combine together and make one water molecule. So the molecule can be made up of atoms of the same element or different element. So this is, see, an oxygen molecule are made up of a two oxygen atom, and that is it contains atoms of only the element oxygen. Here also two hydrogen atom, and here it contains atoms of only the element hydrogen. But here little bit different. The in water molecules are made up of two hydrogen atom and one oxygen atom. That's why it contains atom of both hydrogen and oxygen element. So now the molecules that contains atoms of at least two different elements are called compound. So what is compound? What is compound? The molecules that contain atoms of at least two different elements are called compounds. So the molecules that contain atoms of at least two different elements are called compound. So for example, hydrogen molecule and oxygen molecule. Here already we see the in hydrogen molecule are contains of atoms of the same element. What is the element? It is hydrogen. So the it contains the atoms of the of only the element hydrogen, and here that it contains atoms of only the element oxygen. So that's why we cannot say this is compound. It is not compound, because in definition we see the molecules that contain atoms of at least two different elements, but here have same element. So that's why it is not compound. Next example is the water molecule H2O. Here have one oxygen. See, in water molecule one oxygen atom and two hydrogen atom. So in water molecules is made up of the atoms of one oxygen atom and two hydrogen atom. That's why it contains atoms of the both hydrogen and oxygen elements. So it contains the atoms of both hydrogen and oxygen element. That's why here have two different elements, hydrogen and oxygen. So in definition we notice molecules that contain atoms of at least two different elements are called compound. So this is compound. Understood? So now that another example I want to show you, think about that. Next is that concept of atoms and molecules. Now this is, you think that this is pond. So pond, in pond what is inside of it? It is full of water. Now if we transfer a small amount of water to the pond, to that small amount of water from pond to the tank, water tank. So this is our water tank. We transfer small amount of water from pond to tank. So what is the happening here? So in here, in pond, this water we can use in many purposes, like washing, cleaning, drinking, etc. But when we transfer small amount water from pond to tank, so what is the changes? The substance is still same water, but change only the amount of water. In here, this water also we can use in same purpose, like drinking, washing, etc. Now if we transfer a small amount of water from water tank to bucket, so this is our bucket. So what will happen? Happening is that here is that only change the quantity of water. So when we transfer water from water tank to a bucket, only change the amount of water. But substance is still same. What is the substance? Is it? Is the substance is water. And in with this water, we can use it in same purpose, like drinking, washing, cleaning. So now, if we transfer a small amount of water from the water bucket to a glass. So what is happening here? Only we change the amount of water, but substance is still same. What is it? It's water. So now if we take 1 spoon of water, so here the substance is still same, but only change the amount or quantity of water. Now if you take 1 drop of water, so 1 drop of water, here also the substance is still same water. Now if we break this water, 1 drop of water, we see million of water molecule inside of it. So now if we take 1 water molecule, so 1 water molecule, for further subdivided it, we can see in water molecules there have 2 hydrogen atom and 1 oxygen atom. So one thing you notice here, from pond to tank, tank to bucket, bucket to glass, glass to spoon, and spoon to a drop of water, and that water drop to a water molecule, up to this the substance will be same. The substance is it? What is the substance? Is water. But when we further subdivided it, it is no longer is a water. When we subdivided it, we will get 2 hydrogen atom and 1 oxygen atom. Okay? So in molecule and the atom, they are very small in size. So even we cannot see even under a powerful microscope. But scientifically, one thing is established, that the molecules and the atoms, they are in a state of continuous motion. So how can I know that they have a continuous motion? It is very easy. When you burn any incense sting, what will happen? If you are burning the stings in corner of a room, but the fragrance will spread all around our room. And if you take 1 glass of water, and if you drop 1 drop of ink, after some time you see that the whole water gradually converted into blue ink. Okay, so if you take 1 glass of water and if you add a 1 drop of blue ink, so you will observe that after sometimes the water in that glass is fully converted into blue ink. So now the another example is that when you enter your house, then very quickly you can smell that aroma of food being cooked in the kitchen. Okay. So the molecules and atoms have a continuous state of continuous motion To understand the movement of atoms and molecules in a substance, we need to study the kinetic theory of matter. So, in my next video, I will explain that kinetic theory of matter, what is the postulate of the kinetic theory of matter, and the change of state, and the transfer of heat, etc. Okay, thank you, student.